experiences, some influenced and some imaginary. And I think that each piece, they obviously have a very unique story to tell. And I'm sure the artist can elaborate on that if you chat to him. But Ndaka started off he's actually an engineer by trade, but he's always had a keen interest in the arts, sketching and doodling, and it's something that's been a big part of his life and very consistent throughout. But he didn't really ever consider having a career in arts. It was something that he didn't know was an option or something to do. So it was a bit of circumstance, a bit of life, and I think a series of events that brought him to this place. And as an artist, as a creator, we explored a lot of different methods over the last, over many years actually, since he was quite young. And now he's finally narrowed it down. And has taken part in a lot of group exhibitions and been quite involved in the arts industry over the last couple of years. The most recent accolade was doing the Beijing International Art Biennale. That was one specific piece that was featured there, which I think is really awesome. So, just a few notes on Ndaka's work. Of course, here most of it that we see is what he's narrowed down to, and it's the very intricate work of Dan and String. Ndaka has two assistants that he works with that assist him in bringing his sketches and his vision to life. If you look behind you over there, that piece over there left out is probably the most intricate in this exhibition and has more than 22,000 names. So if you can imagine, I don't know if I would be able to keep my head clear on what goes where, but so him and his team managed to do that and really bring these intricate works to life. Production can take anything between five days to 3 months, depending on the piece and the intricacy they are. But if you'd like to know more about each specific piece, please join us tomorrow for the Artist World Blog, and you can inundate him with all the questions that you have about each specific piece. But tonight we're here to celebrate, and we're here to celebrate your first solo exhibition. Congratulations and welcome. We are really, really honored and proud that you are sharing this milestone in your career with us, and we hope that we can celebrate many more. So, to the artist.
So if you want to know more about the pieces, you're welcome to come through. I'll be here during the course of the night, so you can ask me questions and all that. So I don't really want to say much today, but I just really want to say I really appreciate you guys being here, and I hope you enjoy the exhibition. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.
You know, that's always a difficult question to answer.
Because for me, it's the first time, and I've seen, as you can see, I've seen quite some exhibitions, and I have never seen something like this before.
Man, it just happened randomly. This is something that, a technique that I learned way back in art class, like in grade 5, but we did it, you know, basic, like putting little pins into a board, and then adding strings, making little butterflies and hearts. So nothing this intricate. So I just happened to have the materials at home because I come from a construction background. I had ceiling boards and nails and stuff. try to do something with it, and yeah, ran with it from there.
Very good.
Thank you.
I'm coming outside.
What's going on? Let me tell you.
Thank you.